Nigel, four players who've come through the academy, the Swans under 23 setup, played in the first team at the weekend. Yep. You must be very proud and pleased about that.
Really good weekend, I have to be honest. As I said, there were four players in the first team. Two of them, Connor and Joe, have come through here from under 8s and under 9s. And obviously Ollie McBurney and Jay Fulton, who'd come in to the 23 squad, worked with them, helped them develop. And of course, they've both gone on now and played in the first team. And with Ollie making his senior debut in the Scottish team, which has been a really good season.
The manager said that everybody in the academy should be proud about Joe Roden's graduation to the first team. He's not the only one. How does it make you feel down here at Landor when these players get through to the first team?
I think it just gives the staff a little bit of confirmation that what we're doing is going in the right direction, that we've got a coaching programme, we've got a big investment from the board, from the owners, from the chairman, in terms of how we've looked at developing the youth system in Swansea. And when we get players through, it just means that, okay, we've got a lot of work to do, but we're going in the right direction. From a player's perspective, it definitely shows that there is a pathway from academy football into the first team. If you're prepared to work hard, you've got the attitude, the facilities are here. It's just a matter of doing that. So it was a massive lift on Saturday. I was away with the 60s and 80s at Fulham, and when the news came through that he was starting, the whole bus race went up in arms and say, how excited we were. It was brilliant.
I think Joe grew up just behind the trees behind you. He joined the club aged 8,
yes,
I think.
Yeah.
Has he long been one that you thought had a chance of making the first team?
Yes, we've always had a lot of potential with Joe. Joe's work ethic and his attitude and his passion to play for the club have always been at the forefront. And as a group of staff, we've always felt that he had the potential to make the transition. And obviously, the current manager's given him that opportunity, and it's great. And I mean, it's early days, obviously, but, for him to play, and, he's played particularly well. And as I'm sure lots of people are aware, he was in the EFL Team of the Week. And from your debut, that takes a bit of doing. So, we were thrilled.
Conor Roberts, another local boy.
Yeah.
He broke through midway through last season, didn't he? But again, is he a player who you've had high hopes for?
Again, Connor's attitude and work ethic is absolutely outstanding. Connor would come into the gym all the time. He would stop him sometimes because of his own to have a rest period. For us last season to have a Premier League debut, and also that he made his Premier League start within the first team was exceptional for the academy again. So it goes to show the pathway is open. Ollie McBurney, the same thing. He'd made a number of debuts. He'd made his debut, but then he made his full debut, which again, from our perspective here, shows that sort of pathway is through. And we mustn't forget Adnan Maric and Dan James made their first team debut in the FA Cup. So again, last season was, I think, hopefully a benchmark for us as an academy of what's to come in terms of what's coming through this environment. And I think a little bit of patience, lots of hard work, and I think, there are lads here, I think it'll do us proud when they get on that first team.
Yeah, because when you look back over, I don't know, maybe the last 10 years or so, there's been the odd one, hasn't there? Joe Allen, Ben Davis.
Yeah.
Are you hopeful now that with the investment that's been made in the academy, the facilities you have here now, that there'll be a more of a steady flow of players making it all the way to the first team?
Yes, I hope so. I mean, I think it's very difficult to break into the Premier League from a young player's perspective. I think the Championship gives the boys possibly a different pathway. I wouldn't say easier, because the Championship is a very rigorous and difficult environment for the boys to break into. But what's important is our 23s group have been very effective and competitive for the last two or three seasons, culminating in this being in Division 1 last season and Premier League 2, playing against top sides with first team players dropping in that environment. We've also been involved in the Chequered Trade Trophy, which is a senior games programme. So the boys have had exposure and have been challenging for these opportunities by playing in a senior environment. Joe had been at Cheltenham and made 10 to 12 appearances again, so just set him ready for that. Again, for us this season, I think we've had possibly the best start as an academy. 9 players have been involved with the first team in pre-season, gone away on pre-season tour. That allowed the under-18 staff players from the 18s group going into the 23s. We had a couple of 16s travelling with the 18s when they went away to the Czech Republic. So in terms of a pathway, this has probably been the best season we've had. Graham Porter has been brilliant with the staff here. We've already had a CPD session with Graham. Billy Reid has been out watching the boys, Bjorn is back and forth watching the training sessions. What that does for the players is they realise that they're being watched in terms of a positive opportunity that might arise when they want to go on the first team. Now, that always hasn't always been the environment for them, and that's nobody's fault. But now that it is here, these lads have got to take this opportunity with two hands. And the fact that, you know, the manager is the communication with, you know, Cameron Torshak and Gary Richards and the first team management team is very evident, which is good for the players. The whole environment at the moment, there's a very positive vibe here, and I think from an academy perspective and the first team, you know, the average age on Saturday for our first team, I believe, was 23. You know, it'll be interesting to find out what the other teams are, but I think that's just looking massively forward. The average age last night for the 23s was 20, so that's coming down. So all of a sudden, you can see these young players coming through and take the opportunity. So I apologise for talking a lot, but you know, there's a big passion here for this academy and to get boys into the first team.